This is a MH1210F temperature controller. These are readily available out of Hong Kong or China. If you look around, you'll find somebody in California that's selling these. They're 110 volt and degrees Fahrenheit. Pretty reasonably priced, and you'll have it within a week. The wiring diagram in here is pretty straightforward. If you can't follow the wiring diagram on this, you might want to get somebody to help you with the wiring. Trying to figure out how to program this can be a bit of a headache, especially if you're trying to follow the instructions. And hopefully this quick video will help you with figuring out how to operate this. When you get the instruction sheet for this, it's not necessarily straightforward as to how this works. You have an S and an R, which is a set and a reset button, and the up and down arrows, which is to increment through your settings. If you just press S and let go of it, this will start flashing, and you can increase or decrease the set temperature or the upper limit for the controller. Press that again, and it'll come back, and now it's indicating the temperature that the probe is actually seeing. If I press and hold S for a few seconds, I get to H and C. Press that again, I'm at H. Press an up button, I'm at C, back to H. H is heating, C is cooling. You're going to leave it on heating. Press that again, the up button. We come to CP, which is temperature difference. I push S. I have it set at 1 degree. I can make that 2 degrees. And I can't go any lower than 1 on the Fahrenheit controller. Back to CP, low alarm, which comes set at minus 58 degrees. High alarm, which was 200 and something degrees on this unit. I have it set back at 194, which I think is what it was supposed to be. Turn that back on again. Go to the next one, which is PU, is a delayed start. I have that set at 0, so it, when it gets 1 degree below the set temperature, it comes back on immediately. CA is a temperature correction. If the probe is a bit off, you can correct that. And if I hit reset, we're back to reading the actual temperature. Now that's thrown out there pretty quick, but that's how it works. The instruction sheet for this, for 110 volts, says this will handle 10 amps. I have it hooked up to a 250 watt element, and that'll handle that all day. So that's a lot of information. That's how it works. You can hook these up on a beer cooler, or your thermostat goes out on your refrigerator. You could plug one of these things into the side of it and be back in business pretty quick. And if the relay in here is not big enough to handle it, you could hook this up to operating another relay that is rated at a higher amperage.